Good afternoon, students. During our morning lecture, we have already studied about the general characteristics of class Aves. So now we will study about the classification of Aves. So class Aves is classified or divided into two subclasses based on their character. Okay, and based on these characters, the class Aves have divided into two subclasses. Subclass 1 if called or termed as Archaeoornithes, and the subclass 2 is termed as Neoornithes. Okay. Subclass 1, that is Archaeoornithes, refers to the Archaeo means ancient and ornithus means bird. So this include an ancient birds, okay? And the members of this subclass are extinct. That is, the birds belong to this subclass 1, that is the Archaeoornithes, are extinct, and these birds are live during the Mesozoic era, okay? They were having a long tail which is around 10 which is around 13 or more than 13 caudal vertebrae. It was having a phagostyle which were absent, and the metacarpals are free, okay? That is the bones of limbs, palm. And the free fingers of the four limbs will be ended with the claws. Okay, the tachodont teeth were seen. Okay. Then the subclass, subclass, that is Neoornithes, refers to the new means new, and ornithus means bird. So these are the birds which are new or modern birds, okay? And this Neoornithes subclass include both existing plus extinct bird, okay? And they were having a tail which is end up with the phagostyle. Okay, and the retractiles are arranged in a R semicircle. Okay, that is around phagostyle. And the teeth are absent in some, in many of the forms, the teeth are absent. Okay, so beak have been developed. And here the sternum is well developed, and it will be showing a keel which is help in the attachment of the flight muscle. This the subclass Archaeoornithes is further classified into order Archaeopterygii forms, okay, only one order, whereas the subclass Neoornithes is further classified into super orders. Okay, the first super order referred to as the Odontognathae, which are extinct. Then second super order is Paleognathae, okay. Then third is the super order Empinae, and fourth superorder is Neognathae. Okay, this superorder 1, 2, 3, and 4 are further classified into different orders. Okay, that we will study further in details. Okay, so we'll start with the subclass Archaeoornithes. As I have already told you, this Archaeoornithes are the ancient bird. Okay. They are the most primitive and the extinct fossil bird which were found during the Jurassic period. Okay. And they will be having a jaws which does not bear a teeth. Okay. And Archaeoornithes had a long tail, long feathered tail were present. Okay. And they had a reptile-like elongated body. And in this Archaeoornithes, the four limbs had a three clawed digits. Four limbs, and they had a small brain and eye, एंड ऑल्सो द बोन्स आर नॉन न्यूमेटिक दैट इज इन द मॉडर्न बर्ड्स द बोन्स आर हॉलो दैट विल रिफर टू एज अ न्यूमेटिक ओके सो बट हियर द बोन्स आर नॉन न्यूमेटिक दैट इज इट विल बी फिल्ड विद द बोन मैरो एंड वर कैपेबल इन अ लेस स्पेशलाइज फॉर एंड इट इज लेस स्पेशलाइज फॉर द फ्लाइट दे हैड अ वेल डेवलप्ड बीक ओके देन नेक्स्ट इज दिस सब क्लास आर्कियोऑर्निथिस इंक्लूड अ फाइलम ऑर्डर वन इंक्लूड अ ऑर्डर दैट इज ऑर्डर वन आर्कियोप्टेरजी फॉर्म्स ओके दिस आर्कियोप्टेरजी फॉर्म्स हैड अ टेल विच वॉज लॉन्ग विद द डिस्टल टेपरिंग एंड ओके एंड द फोर लिम्स हैड अ रेमिजेस विद द थ्री क्लॉड डिजिट्स ओके एंड फोर लिम्स एंड द हेड हैज अ लार्ज हेड वॉज अ लार्ज विद अ प्रपोर्शनेटली लार्ज आई ओके एज यू कैन सी इन द पिक्चर एंड दे हैड अ स्ट्रॉन्ग जोस विच विल बी एनेमल्ड विद द क्राउन टीथ And here the cerebral hemisphere was smooth, long and narrow with the small cerebellum. The examples which are included in the order Archaeopteryx forms are Archaeopteryx lithographica. Okay? The another one is Archaeoornis seminis. The picture which is shown in the PPT is the Archaeopteryx lithographica. Okay, then next is subclass Neoornithes. All the modern birds which are present now belong to the subclass Neoornithes, and this subclass contain about 10,000 known living birds, okay, species throughout the world, and this represents a subclass first which is appeared during the Cretaceous period of the Mesozoic era and this also includes some subclasses this subclass also includes some orders which are or super orders which are now extinct or which include some extinct bird okay So, the subclass Neoornithes, the main characters are which are observed in this is they have a well-developed sternum, okay? And sternum, if sternum is well-developed, it will be having a huge kilt. And this kilt is help for the attachment or provide a surface area for the attachment of flight muscle. And flight muscle is very important for the flight locomotion. The next point is they do not bear long tail with the no they do not bear a long tail and the teeth are also the teeth were absent okay on both jaws in some case the teeth are replaced by the horny structure referred to as a bill and this bill are and this bill or the are absent few were in some species of the extinct birds were showing a bill or beak but the teeth were also present in some extinct form okay and the third one is the here the four limbs become the modified into wings so this is the Neoornithes subclass in which both extinct and the living birds are included okay this subclass Neoornithes the classified into super one super order Ordonognathae then super order 2 Paleognathae super order 3 Empinae and super order 4 Neognathae okay So now, superorder Ordonognathae includes all Odontos means teeth and gnathos means jaw. So odonognathae will be having a teeth jaw. Okay. So here they were the referred to as a new world tooth birds. Okay. And they were found in the upper Cretaceous period of the Mesozoic era, that is the 100.5 to 60 MYA, okay, and a million years ago. And they had a short tail with a plowshare shaped phygostyle. Okay, they also have a well developed carina for flight muscle. This carina or the it also function like a keel. Okay, and here the both jaws were present with the teeth. Okay, and they were having a they were a flightless birds, but have well specialized but their forelimbs have a well specialized for the swimming type. Okay, and they had a intramandibular articulation, and the sternum did not bear a keel, but the wings had a vestigial humerus or humerus only, which will be functioning in the case of keel, but not as perfectly or the specialized form how the keel is performing. But here the vestigial humerus will be present or work to take over the function of the keel. Okay, then next is the this superorder Odonognathae is divided into different orders. That is, first one is order 1, referred to as a Hesperornithiformes. Okay, and these are extinct. Okay, the members of this order are extinct. They were called as a extinct aquatic birds and are inhibited in both freshwater and the marine habitat in the north hemisphere. Okay, and they were having a flightless predator. They were flightless predator which are very strong or perform dives with a strong swimming behavior. Okay, their body size may reach maximum length of about or over 1.5 meter. Okay, and they were having a long neck with the heterocoelous vertebrae. Four limbs had a vestigial humerus only. Okay, and both jaws have pointed teeth, but the premaxilla did not bear teeth. Okay, and here the hind limbs are bought or modified for the web into the web fit. Okay, the example of this is Hesperornis. The given picture is the of Hesperornis. Okay, the next one is order Ichthyornithiformes, and this order, the member of this Ichthyornithiformes is extinct. Okay, the representative of this order Ichthyornithiformes was small sized marine flying bird which are found during the upper Cretaceous of the Cretaceous of North America. They were found throughout the late Cretaceous period, that is 65 million years ago of the North America, and they become extinct during the Cretaceous Paleogene boundary. Okay, and they had a amphicoelous vertebrae in a neck region, and they were also having a well developed keel in the sternum with the fused clavicles. The example of this is Ichthyornis. Okay, the given picture is of the Ichthyornis. Then next is the I think this is enough for today's lecture. In next lecture we will continue the classification of apes. Okay, that is we'll start with the we have done only superorder 1. So three super orders are remaining. If you have any question, then please let me know. And student, remember for this journal completion, you were asking me about for the classification of AVEs. You can draw this only in your journal. Okay, for batch, I don't remember the batch. I think it is Thursday's batch. Friday's batch. Friday's batch, please remember, you can copy this classification only on your journal and get it ready, completed. Okay? And if you have any question, then let me know. Okay? Thank you.